That's my totem pole, I'm guessing. What it really is like ideas for the title village that I'm going to build. Because I had this old world. This is experiments 2, by the way. So it's my second experiments world. Okay. And in the old world, I had all of these creeper faces symbolizing what kind of village style it's going to be, yeah? And so this is like a prison because of the iron bars, yeah? And give the iron bars use for once. This is industrial and the glass is grey because it's got soot on it and is brick. This is like underground, so stone brick again and then moss stone. Then this is like modern. Oh, that looks cool. So clear glass, and this is the whitest block there was. And then this is like hell. Doomville, as I'm going to call it. Thing is, I didn't get to finish this because it just took too long to do this side. What you rely on is block updates, except you rely for them to not do anything. Like, you need to not have any block updates happening whilst you place this. In fact, I might show you how to do one side. Just so that you know. Like so. Then just cover it all up on this side. So the lava never sees. Also, you need to put blocks underneath where there would be lava. So this block wouldn't be lava, but the one block behind it would have. And the reason you need to put a block there is because when you break these blocks, for example, if you break this block, the lava would update. The lava block here would be updated, yeah. And lava, or any fluid, flows to the closest hole, yeah, goes to the closest gap. So if there wasn't a block underneath that block that I'm pointing at right now, then there would be two holes and lava would also go that way. So, clever. Also, you have to take lava blocks off of the blocks off, starting from the top. Otherwise it will update the blocks from the bottom and then the bottom, yeah, it just won't work, okay? Okay. So wait for all that lava to set in so it doesn't update anything else. Then break these slowly, because once I did it really fast and it just didn't work. Slowly. So as you can see, the lava stays where it was placed because I have these blocks. I can get rid of those two now. I'll give you an example. Yeah, see? Works that way though. Okay. Break all the blocks going from top to bottom. That creates your creeper face of awesomeness. So the dangers of this, of course, is that you can easily jump into it or something, but I don't care. Okay, don't need anything. Don't need these two anymore. Don't need these. And that's one side. Awesome. And of course you'll need a lot of lava. So this world is kind of private, I don't know. What I'll show you in a minute is what I've worked on the village in my LP world. Well, first I'm going to show you this tree farm I did. It's tree farm design. For some reason nothing's loading in. Come on, load in. I don't like the 1.9.332 release, because it's just chunks have problems loading in, and I haven't even finished this thing yet. For some reason I was stupid and decided to like make this go up, which is like the hardest way you could do it, but there is a way around that. And so the tree farm, I kind of got inspiration from Etho's design for the tree farm, or his tree farm. If I remember, I'll put the link in the description. So what happens is there's a block update. If a block grows, yeah, so if the tree grows, there'll be a block update to this, yeah. Whoops. And what that will do, if I can get it back. Well, you can probably hear some pistons working. Put that block right there. So what it does is this is an update sensor, yeah? So this is one of my own designs, actually. So what you have is, to start off with, this kind of like goes back on itself. And that's why I like it so much, because you don't need two separate things, it just goes back on itself. So here you have a torch, yeah? Which, so in total, this is 2 ticks of a delay, yeah? And the wire goes up to here. I'm just telling you this in case you don't know how update sensors work. And there's a diagonal line here of redstone towards this piston now. That doesn't activate it. But if the piston gets a block update, so if something was placed there, or let's say, well, yeah, if something got broken and destroyed or placed there next to the piston, it will open, kind of, yeah. It will extract. That's the word. And what happens then is that this block goes to here, obviously, and the line here switches on, and this switches off, therefore this is now off, yeah? To make it go back, or the piston to retract again, if it's a block update thing, what you need is the line to be off, and there needs to be another update, which is made by this, by these pistons, which push the tree that just grew into here, and it's ready to grow again after the quadruple vertical extender, like the hardest thing you can imagine, is done extending. Now, I have it set so it does the extension twice, because there's like, I'm not sure if it, I think it doesn't keep up or something. So I had to do it twice because one block was getting left out, and here I just have block sensors. So yeah, this works really simply. Now, you would expect for this dust to like do nothing, but in the old Minecraft like beta, the dust was just was a plus sign, and that meant that it went in all four directions if it's on its own, which it is. So it goes to this block. Not anymore. And goes to the piston, which does that. Now I'm just going to break this line of wood, just to do a demonstration. I'm not going to explain to you how the quadruple extender works, but sometimes the tree grows taller than the quadruple extender can reach, so I have these two pistons here in case it does grow further than it should, and just pushes it into its own line. So I will need some bone meal, and I will need some sapling. Currently my design only works for oak, but Etho's design works for everything, but it's complicated for me. He's a redstone wizard, I'm not. So, quick demonstration. I think I was planning to build the tree farm towards C. That works. And goes again. Pushes that over to here. So every time it does a 4-block thing, even though the tree might grow 5 or 6 blocks, that's why I have these 2 blocks here. So, pretty cool there. I was going to show you something else. Oh yeah. First I'll go to the show you my LP world, and then I will show you what I have done. Hello everyone, and welcome back to another episode of DoomSkull Plays Minecraft. This is episode 11, and today, I don't know what to do, but do that nether hub thing, because that's all I've got planned. And I accidentally pressed the stop recording button there, when I was meant to press F5. So welcome back, and lots of things have taken place since last time. I'm just going to go down here to show you. I had the worst crack there. Okay. Oh my god. You see lava? I see it too. Okay. No, I can't sing. So I kind of finished this off. I'm happy enough with it. I just need to make a little tunnel like thing here. Going to the nether. What I have is lava going down from there and a bit from there, and that lights up the path, and same on this side. And then I've got two things going down from there and going straight into these corners. And I have this awesome lava lake like thing, because all the fire is coming from the hell, and it just doesn't have anywhere to go and it just leaks there. Okay. Also, I did a lot more work on the village, like a lot more. By the way, I just turned down my Minecraft sounds to 75% because I noticed it was too loud, and I mean way, way, way too loud. So first off, I got rid of a lot of trees here because they were just annoying, and I needed wood like crazy. The church. Because this is the village, I would never build a church. I have no idea what this is even supposed to be. This is supposed to be like a man. Well, this is supposed to be like sun kind of like thing. Not apocalyptic, weird sun, and that's supposed to be a man with his, like, the sun is behind his head, kind of. AKA Jesus. So, inside the church, I've got an opposite thing there. Inside your church, you obviously have your seats. This is where I have been to a few churches, but I don't go to church. Here is where you would have your books and stuff. I don't actually know what they have there. I never read them. And then here's the pyre. What's it? I don't know. Altar. The altar. Yeah. And I have it raised up here a bit. So that, yeah, just because. I've got nothing here yet, so I don't know what to put here, like storage maybe, but this village already has more than enough storage, and I'll show you what I mean later. Also in the corners of the stairs I have like supports, so it looks realistic. Up here is like one of those bell thingies that you would ring if it's like church time. Also I don't know much about church. What was I about to say? Yeah, I've got some supports here, and I'm generally happy with this church. The main thing I was going for is a tower. That's like all I wanted, a tower. And I think it turned out good enough, for me at least. I emptied this chest pretty much, and I put it into this storage room. I made more paths, and this is a massive storage room, by the way. That's what I meant by this place has enough storage on its own. So I labelled everything stone, gravel and sand, not wood, just tools in general, clay, because I was planning to have things made out of clay blocks here, and glass, redstone, haven't got any in there yet, goodies. Yep. Nether/end. I should have probably made a chest for food. So I'm constantly running out. And also, got the path coming over to here, and I got some mines here. Not that they're really set up. So I got some supports here. I don't know much about mines. I need this stuff here, by the way, so I'm not going to touch it. But, so it goes down to level 11 there, but, here. The main purpose of this is for me to get cobblestone, yeah? And I literally just figured out a way for it to work. Like, because in my old experience world, again, I had this machine that would automatically make cobblestone and then move it into a 10 by 10 block of just cobblestone, and then I could mine it up. Of course, that was in creative mode, but that was like a prototype of it. And I don't know what happened to that world, but when it got corrupted, it never loads up again. Like, it just crashes Minecraft when I would try to load it up. And so I lost the prototype, and it's been over 2 years now, and I wanted to build it again because I needed the cobblestone for this church. What I ended up doing was just making 3 iron picks and mining stuff, just mining a tunnel. So, oh yeah, I've not finished yet. Over here, this is like the smallest change. Because this is water, this log would be wet, so I made it spruce to give it a darker contrast. Also, I've got like this little garden here now. This is wheat, carrots, I think, potatoes, carrots and potatoes, and wheat. I haven't got any beetroot yet, so I just got all that stuff there. I spent a long time in this village. I want to get out of here. And these torches, by the way, represent where a path would go. This is how I usually build my paths. Like, put a torch line and then dig it all up. But today, we're working on a nether hub, like inside the nether, actually. And I think that's going to be, like, one of the biggest projects I'm going to do in this world. Because they're so annoying to do, believe me. By the way, I did remember the recipe for the fence, for the fences, except I forgot it now, because I'm speckled. So I'm just going to collect a bunch of things now, and I'll be back once I'm done. As you can see, I've got nothing more interesting here. Oh yeah, by the way, you may be thinking that I'm spending way too much time on the village, yeah? Well, I think that, but, you don't know what a long time is, guys. You really don't know, then. A long time is a long time. This only took me, like, 3 hours to do, 1 hour for each thing. The shack took, like, 30 minutes, maybe. The church took, like, 1.5 hours, and the mine took me not that long. But I'm just going to show you what did take me a long time, and I've already been there actually before. Been there before with you. But I'm just going to show you again. Because I had that world since the very beginning of like the hunger bars and stuff, the beta 1.8. And yeah, it took a long time to do it around here because it looks pretty nice, doesn't it? Like, you have to admit, this looks perfect, if I could stop lagging for a bit. Like, I've got pathways, like, they're so detailed. And I'm actually starting to forget how I did them, because they look so nice. Of course, I've not done everything here yet, because I, like, kind of stopped going on this world after I did stuff. I've got like, a little garden here. A custom tree. Not too happy with the roots. An enchanting room. Everything's connected by paths here. And I've tried to hide my lighting as much as possible. For example, around here, you can't see many torches. If they are there, you're not supposed to see them anyway. Got a little dock thing. Like, this took a long time to make. Okay? Just okay. And that's not the whole world. In fact, I'll put a link in the description to the world tour of this that I did. And you'll see the whole world. And see why it took such a long time. I think I killed him now. Okay. Alright then, so just before I start making the hub, I need to know where the portal beast will be. And so I just did some quick calculations. So, whoops, screenshot, don't need that. So I just did some quick calculations. In the overworld, I had the nether portal at 89, 75, and 317. So those are the coordinates of the overworld nether portal. Here, they are 18, 81, and 47, but they should be 11, 75, 39. So I'm just going to move this portal to there. This isn't in completely wrong place. Well, okay, so this is where the portal should be, so let's just see if it goes to the right place. Then I'm screwed. Please go to the right place. Yay, it's the right place! Perfect. And we won't hang around there for much longer. So let's just go back and the portal's broken, apparently. Wow. What's wrong with you? I think I broke the network of portals. Okay, it worked. There must be like some cooldown time. Something. That. Ooh, 9 FPS. 3, 1, ooh, 2. Okay. Okay, better. So, not far away from where the portal originally was, just over here originally. Now it's down there. And now I believe we can start actually doing some work. By the way, I just cleared up this room, yeah? We're going to have too much netherrack one day. Soon. So, the reason I dug all that out is because I want to have like a really open nether hub. And, in fact, now that I think about it, I'm going to need a lot of TNT for this. So, maybe instead of blowing up the mountain, we're just going to blow up this episode. Why not do that? Yeah. Although I'll probably have already cleared, cleared it all out because I need to work on this today, not tomorrow. Today. For some reason, in the nether, I get more FPS than in the overworld. I'm guessing that's because of trees and stuff, because trees barely need anything to load. I mean, they need a lot to load. This barely needs anything to load. Oops. Also, whilst we're in the nether, if I see any casts, I'll be sure happy to hunt them down. And in fact, why not we take a look at them now, see if there's anything there. I had a fight with a pigman the other day, and I hope they forgave me. I left the area so they would have despawned. Yeah, it looks like they forgave me, because they only get aggro from other pigmen. Oh, crap. What the? That scared me. Cheat. Got no arrows. Okay. I'm pretty bad at fighting ghosts without any arrows. Oh Okay, I can't fight him dead because he's going to lava. And then the dust here is just going to blow up. Yes! Please don't go in lava, yes. Got it. Whew. Nether really is hell. Just as it says in the biomes thingy. So I'm just going to clear out that area and maybe start building something. Alright guys, I've run out of time and these pigmen are extremely annoying. I really want to kill them, but I know I can't. They've been annoying me the whole time I was here. So I kind of dug out a room here. It's just a circle, like, still got quite a bit more to do. In fact, I've got a ton to do. So currently it's just a circle, got a pathway going up to here, which is where there's going to be more stuff, probably a bigger room, and going to be another path over there. I got from all of that, and I've got 13 TNT, but I'm not going to blow it up here, because I'm really not bothered to. And I've spent way too much time in here, had to repair my work pick, once, luckily. Wasted two of my diamonds, which is all I had, really. And we now shall go blow some stuff up, because I'm bored. And because I ran out of time, and yeah. Okay. I really like the way this looks. Looks awesome, I think. Of course, I need to polish up around here and stuff, but that's all going to come later when I'm polishing up the whole world, really. Got a ton of food. I killed the pigs because I was hungry and I was bored as well. I had a bat there. There must be a cave I haven't explored yet. I for some reason I just don't like caving that much. I used to love it, but I don't anymore. I don't know why, I just don't. I'm okay with it. I think something's not fun with it anymore. It's probably that there might not just be enough resources or not enough action. I don't know. Well, there's plenty of action, you die all the time. Yeah, I've gone a bit too far here. Okay. How much do I have? 13, so... going to do something like this. Coal ore is pretty useless unless you fortune it. I think this was a pretty good episode. Most of it has been off camera, but I doubt that you would have wanted to see me do a ton of building. It didn't even take that long, really. Okay, how much do I have? I've got 5 left, so. Actually, you know what? I'm going to do it like this. Because I'm special. Whatever it is, I don't know. That's the block where it's going to be on. Actually, let's do it like this. So, we can do it like so. Go up here, eat, and let's blow this baby up. Okay. Are you kidding me? Wow, I'm out of arrows. Why don't you make a pathway up? Okay. Run. Shit. Yep. Should have gotten some arrows first. Thanks for watching. And... ooh, nice. I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys.